The Independent National Electoral Commission has declared the All Progressive Congress winner of the Saturday governorship election in Edo State, according to the resigning officer, who is the Vice Chancellor of the Federal University of Technology, MENA, Professor Farouk Abdamukuta. The APC candidate, Senator Monday Okpebholo, pulled 291,667 votes to defeat his arch rival Aswa Ighodalo of the People's Democratic Party, who secured 247,274 votes. The APC won in 11 local government areas, while the PDP 7. The APC won the 6 local government in Edo North Senatorial District and 2 out of the 5 local government in Edo Central Senatorial District. Beyond the loss and victory, this report focused on the individuals who played a key role in the election and contributed to its outcome. Nyesonwike. At the time, the APC denied Obaseki returning ticket in the build-up to the 2020 Edo governorship election. Nyesonwike, then the governor of Rivers State, and some other PDP gave him a solid backing to secure the party's ticket. Nwike, now the Minister of the Federal Capital Territory, FCT, worked for Obaseki's victory against APC Osage Ezeiyamo in the 2020 election. Not long after his re-election, Obaseki and Nwike fell apart. In fact, Obaseki supported former Vice President Atiku Abubakar against Nwike as the presidential candidate of PDP in the last election. Nwike would later turn an apology to Senator Adams Oshomele, Obaseki's estranged godfather, to forgive him for helping Obaseki win re-election. The FCT minister in the build-up to the Saturday's election stated that he would not support the People's Democratic Party's candidate Aswa Ighodalo, having fallen out with Obaseki. During an interview, Obaseki said Edo voters do not need Nwike's influence to decide who they would vote for. At a point, the PDP, through its Edo State Chairman, Dr. Anthony Osagbemi, demanded redeployment of the state rec, Anungbe Onoha, as the Commissioner of Police CP, Nemi Edwin Iwo, over their alleged ties with Nwike. Nwike dismissed allegation of him influencing the appointment of his cousin Onoha as the resident electoral commissioner in Edo State, warning propagandists that nobody born of a woman can intimidate his cousin. Philip Shaibu. During the rift between Obaseki and Oshomole in 2020, Shaibu stood behind Obaseki against Oshomole, noting that the former governor was playing godfather when they both never allowed such to happen in Edo State. Like Nwike, Shaibu was another key factor in securing Obaseki's re-election. He particularly took the political battle to Obaseki's doorstep, attacking with foul language at different fora. However, the table turned as Shaibu fell out with Obaseki over his governorship ambition. Obaseki didn't only deny him PDP ticket, he masterminded his impeachment. There was a twist in July as Shaibu was reinstated as the deputy governor by Justice James Omotosho of the Federal High Court in Abuja. Following his reinstatement, Shaibu defected to the All Progressive Congress alongside 7 key PDP legacy coalition members. Shaibu's eviction to a large extent depleted PDP's strength going into Saturday's election. He described Obaseki's candidate as an outsider, saying he would rather back APC candidates. Dan Obihi, former National Vice Chairman South-South of the People's Democratic Party and the immediate past Edo Chairman of the party, is another political leader who worked against Ighodalo's victory. Obihi, one of the allies of Nwike, did not hide his hatred for Obaseki and his appointed candidate. He is the leader of the legacy group comprising leaders of PDP who worked for Obaseki's victory in 2020. The group members were at loggerhead with governor for not fulfilling promise he made to them during the Edo State 2020 election. When Ighodalo emerged party's candidate, Obihi declared he would not support him. In fact, he rejected PDP's governorship campaign council membership. The leader of anti-Obaseki legacy coalition, who hails from Esako Central Local Government Area in Edo North, said, "Nobody told me of any governorship campaign council membership in Edo PDP. I'm not aware of it." In June, pro-Obaseki PDP leaders expelled Obihi from the party for alleged anti-party activities. The party said it also expelled Shaibu and Honorable Moregi Obedi, an immediate past House of Rep member representing Oredo Federal Constituency. Ojezwa is another Obaseki's ally turned political enemy. He was state chairman of the Edo State Chapter of APC and led members of the executive from state to ward to pitch tent with the PDP when Obaseki was denied returning ticket in 2020. In leading the party's leaders, he cited loss of confidence in the national leadership of the APC and alleged disobedience to the party constitution. The resolution, which was signed by 22 members of the executive of the party, led Ojezwa and chairman of the party across the 18 local government areas of the state, said over 150,000 supporters of their supporters have concluded plans to defect with them. However, Ojezwa, like Shaibu, fell out with Obaseki over the governorship ambition on the platform of PDP. After Obaseki's man emerged PDP candidate, Ojezwa fought the primary and dragged Ighodalo to court. Ojezwa said he sought redress in court because Obaseki played a huge role in ensuring that the primary was not transparent. Early this month, a court of appeal, Abuja Division, dismissed Ojeswa's suit seeking disqualification of Ighodalo's candidacy. Kabiru Adjoto is a former speaker of the Edo House of Assembly who defected from PDP after falling out with Obaseki. There were allegations that he fell out with Obaseki over his failure to name his deputy after the controversial impeachment of Shaibu. Obaseki named Marvelous Omobaya as his deputy, a development which reportedly set him up against Adjoto. At a meeting of legacy group head at Obihi's country home in Ogbana, Adjoto tackled Obaseki over his failure to manage the 2020 electoral victory. He said that instead of concentrating on the victory recorded in 2020 election by rewarding those who worked for his re-election, Obaseki opted for others in the party who did not work for the party.
Very well. Everything and anything that God cannot do does not exist.
Thank you.
And that is why when ordinary men and women boast of their power, those with wisdom know that power resides only with God. And those who win it on the planet Earth are only the few that God has so anointed. And that is why when some people say election is a do or die, we say no. It's about choice, it's about celebration of the power of the ordinary citizen to hire and fire people who otherwise can even sign death sentence. Now, today, God by his infinite powers has decreed Senator Monde Akpakomiza, alias Akpako Rescue. Some now call him Akpako Miracle because they don't need all of that to make up for the 8-year disaster of Obaseki and Aswe together.
Yes.
So on this day, I am very, first we give thanks to God Almighty that we did all those campaigns without casualty, that we did all those campaigns without any allegation against the candidate and any one of us for physical violence on anyone. Even when they planned and they did succeed in killing the bodyguard in order to frighten him, God said, my son, who I have anointed, will not be frightened.